Morning all, hope you're well. I just arrived in Westminster and today is an unusual day. I'm going to Buckingham Palace to meet the Queen. She's invited a bunch of technology people to come and have a reception at her house, which is very nice of her. But first I'm going to Parliament because Givi has been included in a government research paper for how to change the flipping giving culture in the UK. So a very cool day. I got dressed up especially and I'll try and take you with me as best I can.
All we need is a spark, a second chance, a lifeline. Waiting up in the dark, holding up for a searchlight. No, I don't know why seasons change or how we fell so far. For our hearts go up in flames, let's go through.
But the vital question is, how can we make this change happen?
So I think what we're calling for in this report, and as David said, it is really a transformation, and really quite a radical overhaul in the way that employers help their employees to connect with charities and with social action. Now, absolutely, we have lots of great examples of companies, big and small, doing great things. And so there are some recommendations in the report to actually help employers to be able to do that sort of matching, which really does, all the evidence says, makes a really big difference. Lots of young people are far more likely to want to work for an employer who's involved in this.
Employees want to feel proud of where they work. The best businesses know that, and the best businesses know they have to support and recognise and value what their employees want to do in that.
That was a lot of fun and good to catch up with some old faces, and really exciting that most of the stuff that gets talked about in this report Givi absolutely nails, and it really gets me fired up again. And now to go over to the lady's house who all these guys and girls in Parliament work for. So this is the invite I got from the Queen a few days ago. I'm going to show you what's in it.
Let the heat of the sun reignite your memory.
So I've written my note to the Queen because I figure people probably don't really say thank you to her because they're probably scared of her. So I want to say thanks to her for inviting me round, but that I'd love to chat with her more because I know she cares about giving and about how we treat one another. So may as well give her my number and see whether she wants to chat further. And Ella wrote, I know she's busy, but this is quite an important issue. Well, she's got my number. She can do what she wants. I am now pulling into the Mall, the driveway to the Queen's house, basically. So I might have to switch over to my iPhone in a second. Okay, so I'm now sitting outside Buckingham Palace waiting for my car to get checked, like these guys. Should I take the whole thing off?
Yeah, I should leave it because I'll just slip it on there.
Perfect.
Okay, no problem.
Thank you. I don't know why no one's taking photos of my car.
Just send it to
Anna. No worries. Here we go, going into the gates. Well, this is probably the only time I'll ever drive through the gates at Buck Pal.
Excuse me?
Yeah, man.
Are you going to see the Queen now?
Hopefully.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, cool. Good luck.
Thank you, man. Yeah.
No problem.
It's good fun, isn't it?
Thanks, yeah.
Good evening.
Just speak to my colleague.
Sure. Hi, sir.
Can I see your green invitation
card? Yes, that's here.
Excellent, and a photo, excellent.
Thank you, sir.
Have a good afternoon. Just pop up behind one of those vehicles.
One of those rather nicer looking vehicles. Thank you. Well, hello, sir. Now to hand deliver my note to the Queen, hopefully, unless I get rugby tackled in the process. So that's it, the end of the night, we're the last ones here. Met Prince William, met the Queen, had a nice chat with Prince William, met the Duke of Edinburgh, met Michael Birch from Bebo, a bunch of other guys, and it's time to go home before they lock me up for the night. But what a great day, Gibby getting established. Let's see what happens next. See you soon, guys.
I should have hired a car as well.
I've just driven home and got changed, and I guess I'm beginning to reflect on the day. And it was pretty nuts, pretty awesome. So glad I got to drive into the palace. That was freaking awesome. But it was kind of weird meeting the Queen, because you just go past and shake a hand and move on. Your name gets called out, but she can't. She doesn't have enough time to take in any of your story or who you actually are. So it's almost like a non-human experience. It's not like meeting anybody else ever. But meeting Prince William was totally different. He's engaging and listening. He moves on after a minute or two, but at least he's sort of heard who you are. So I don't envy her life at all. And I can only just hope that she has some real mates of her own that she gets to hang out with, whether that's up in Scotland or whatever. But what a great day. Thanks for coming with me. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you soon.